So next problem, let me take one circle, okay? Let me take one circle, and this circle is placed parallel to HP, and it was perpendicular to VP, and it's going to make angle of inclination 45 degree, okay? So once you are seeing from normal top view and front side view, you will get one small line, and top side view, you will get the circle. Whatever the diameter we are given, you will get. But if it is 45 degree inclined or 30 degree, 60 degree inclined, means from the top view, you will not able to see it as a circle, somewhat different. At the end, we will see how it is going to looks like. Okay. When you are seeing in the front side view, it will become a line with 45 degree angle of inclination. So problem is, it was parallel to HP, perpendicular to VP, and it's having 45 degree angle of inclination with HP. So that is a problem. Now slowly we can reproduce it. Let me draw the front side view first. Okay. So front side view will be placed in the VP. Let me take some diameter. Okay. This will be. Then I'm going to use the construction line to make it here. Assume that if the diameter is 60 mm. So I'm going to make. So this distance will be in 60 mm. So I have to mark the center. Okay. So for this purpose, you can use front side view, top side view, anything you can draw it first. Okay. If you want, first draw the top side view. Okay. If I make the circle, for me, I just making one small circle over here. Okay. Then divide it into four parts. If you want, you can divide it into eight number of parts. Okay. Equal number of parts. Now I going to give A, B, C, D, and this origin O. Then you can extend this line. You make this thing so A, B, C can be visible from the front side view. Okay, come. So this four circle have a four divisions, major divisions. This one and this one. So if this one is A and this division is coming here, that's a B and this is C and D is hidden. If I placing like this, because parallel to HP, perpendicular to VP. So A, B, C is visible, D is invisible. Okay. So when you are going for front side view, so A visible, and you have to extend this line for B visible, C visible. As I told, you have to put dash. Okay. But back side of B, that is D, is invisible. Put it in the bracket. Now problem is first stage over. Second stage, it was inclined to 45 degree. So it was inclined to 45 degree means it was here and parallel to HP, then making 45 degree angle of inclination like this. So when you are seeing from the front side, you will have the angle of inclinations. Okay. If they are given certain height from HP, you have to measure that height. After that only you have to mark the angle of inclination. If it is not, no problem, just extend that line and we will make it. Okay. Just that here. So you add one extended line over here. Okay. Then you mark one point, and we know that this is 60 mm. 60 mm. So this length of line also 60 mm. And I told it's making 45 degree angle of inclination. So extend line, make 45 degree angle of inclination. You know 60 mm, cut the arc. Now you place A dash. Okay. Now you have to measure the distance between A to B and put the arc over here. That is B dash. Not only is this C dash, and here we have D dash. That's invisible. Okay. After that, use construction line. Drop the lines like this. Okay. Then from here, D extended line. From A, C extended this line, B extended this line. Now the real thing is we have to check D is here, right? D is here, right? So this line is coming here, and this D was, D dash was here. So match those lines, D, D dash. So this will be the new D. Okay. If you want, put 1, 1, 1, 1. Okay. We'll give D 1 here. Now it's over. Then A, C. A was here, so mark it here, A1. C was here, mark it as a C1, center, O. Okay. Another one is B. B line, horizontal line is coming, vertical line is coming over here. Now B1. So after finishing all those things, just try to connect. Okay, it's supposed to be an ellipse. I think without any apparatus I'm making, so that it will be like this only, but it will be ellipse. Sometimes if they are giving, suppose it was 60 mm above HV, means you have to measure the distance, it should be 60 mm. After measuring the distance only, you have to do this drawing. It's very simple. Okay, so it will be like this. Again the same sum, we have finished up to one angle of inclination, right, with respect to HP. For the same sum, if it is angle of inclination with respect to VP, okay, if it is VP, angle of inclination is 45 degree, means it was like this, now it was like this, because having 45 degree inclination to HP. Again we have one more twist, that is, it is angle of 45 degree with respect to VP, means 45 degree it will rotate like this. Okay, normally it will be like this. For VP means it will rotate like this. Okay, for that we have to check which view will give a full dimensions, then we have to proceed. Okay, for this is a simple sum, and I'm stopping here. The same procedure for all the things, pentagon, hexagon, square, etc., etc. Okay, so this was easy. Now over, it's one angle of inclination. Again, if you have one more angle of inclination, means what you have to do, then again you have to extend these lines over here, and this line over here, and this one also over here, extend it. Now first one is inclination with respect to HP, another one is VP. Now today, students, we have seen the projection of plane, right? Especially for circular profile we have seen, and I have made the problem up to this. Later I have made one small twist, that is, it is inclined to 45 degree of with respect to vertical plane, that is VP. So that is somewhat difficult. I have given some tips, but I don't know whether you guys maybe make it or not. Okay, so I have given the end card, that is final, how it is going to be appear, but in between I have not shown, that means how we are placing A2, C2, B2, D2. That take much more time. So for you guys, I have made this clip. So go through this video clip and watch it carefully, because this is the same procedure we going to follow it for rest of the geometries like pentagon, hexagon, etc. Okay, now students, let me check. Okay, now construct the box and give the names 1, 2, 3, 4 as I have given in the clockwise direction. So here you have to measure the distance from 1 to D1 and D1 to 2, and you can able to measure the distance between 2 to C1, C1 to 3. Otherwise you can measure it from O to C1 and O to A1. Okay, so all the measurements we can take, that is what we need. So second, what I told, it was in 45 degree incline to VP. So 45 degree incline line we have made, and I have measured and I have placed A2 and C2, because I have measured that its distance is 40, so I have constructed that one. But here you can see we have to reproduce the same box again. Okay, and you have to measure the box and reproduce it. Okay, then you can put the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, got it. Then you may able to know the distance between 2 to C1 and 3 to B1, 4 to A1, etc. Right, then you mark those points. Okay, A1, A2, so give it. Then finally you produce the circle, that is appeared as like a oval shape or ellipse. Okay, then what you have to do, then we have to project upward lines from the silent points, that is from A2, B2, C2, D2, etc. You just extend the vertical lines like this direction, and later we have to extend some horizontal lines from the previous projections. Okay, so finally the meeting points of A2 and A1 dash, D2, D1 dash, okay, like this, we will create another points like A2 dash, D2 dash, C2 dash, and mark those points and connect it, you will get a final structure like this. Okay, then the problems will be over. So remaining problems, if it is inclined to two planes, it will be like this only. Try these things and solve it. Okay, thank you.